when you think about dental care and medical care and how sort of segregated they often are, it really doesn't make sense when you're looking at the overall health of a person, because someone's oral hygiene and dental care in general has a major role in their physical health. So one of the things that we try to stress is that especially preventive dental care is essential for people to succeed in school or to be productive in the workplace. And that's a big part of what we try and do, is not only do restorative care for people, but also provide preventive care and the education that people need so that they can be healthier.
The major problem with dental care, in particular for people who are unmedicated in any state, but especially in Wisconsin, is the fact that reimbursement, Medicaid reimbursement to dentists is so low that dentists actually refuse to take Medicaid patients.
The need is significant, and we're trying to grow to be able to meet more of that need.
A dental clinic was definitely needed. And we had originally in 2009 put a four-chair dental clinic in, and by January of 2010, Access Community Health Center was in need of four additional chairs. So that's when we started working on a project to buy the building next to us and tear it down and build a new clinic.
Well, the partnership between FCA and Southwest Capital was meant back many, many years. Actually, as soon as I found out that the service area had changed from, I think it was the Dane Fund to FCI and serving the entire state, I think I was on the phone the next day with Sally asking her for money, which is, you know, what we usually do with FCI. Not only do we appreciate the money, but we appreciate the ability of FCI to understand what it's like to run a non-profit organization and all the needs and the demands, which are different than in the for-profit world. So
we've doubled the size of the number of operatories we have, and that gives us a lot more ability to see more patients. We were in four small operatories, and we were kind of cramped in with the number of people we had, the number of providers. And this gives us a lot more space for the staff we have and also room for expansion in the future. So I think there's more people we'll be able to see. I know we've seen a little over 1,000 people in the last calendar year.
Just thinking about the level of construction jobs on that project, I spoke with the project manager today, and I said, where most of the jobs and the contractors and even the supplies and materials coming from? Oh my gosh, probably 90% of it outside of the dental equipment itself came from a 4 or 5 county area right around here. That's a huge infusion of economic development in your community. The building was built in 1915. It's seen many, many different lives, but now it has a new life, and that is to help the community to grow, confront access to healthcare issues, and to move out of poverty and increase the quality of life for everybody in Dodgeville.
First time in history of our Head Start program, which has been around for decades, every single one of our Head Start children had got to see a dentist or got dental care. That's never happened before, and that was passed on to the Head Start people both in Chicago and in Washington. And that really was an amazing story.
For forward community investments, and also I think for Southwest Cap, the icing on the cake here is that this building represents exactly what we as nonprofits were formed to do, and that is to really make an impact on our community.